What is up, my people, and welcome back to another episode of Tyler Buys Houses. So this week I am in sunny Scottsdale, Arizona at a real estate event, and yes, I pay crazy money to be the dumbest guy in the room. But why do I do that? Well, you cannot go to college for this. I will say that, and I will keep saying it until I'm blue in the face. You have to learn from people who do better than you at what you're trying to be great at. I'm at an event, learning, growing, changing, seeing where I fail, seeing how I measure up or how I'm doing well in certain things. So I'm excited to be the dumbest guy in the room, but I pay 30,000 bucks a year to be part of this coaching. I've spent hundreds of thousands of dollars to have coaching, but I'll tell you what, it has made me millions of dollars. So many people look at this and say, oh my goodness, that costs you too much money, or this is so expensive. I had a guy that I'm mentoring say that a while back. This one course I'm looking at is only 1,000 bucks, and I think I can afford to do that. I would challenge your perspective. You can't afford not to get some coaching. You can't afford not to get some help in your business, and that's what I do. So I go to these events 4 times a year to level up and be part of something bigger than me. It helps me grow to be something bigger than I am now. And that is what today and the rest of the next 3 days is about. So I'll give you a little tour of what happens here, but this event is called The Collective Genius. So let's talk about an event like this and how it happens. And a guy like this has a vision to help people. This is gonna be my YouTube channel that gets tens of views. Okay?
All right.
So you need to take this seriously.
Tens of views.
I am up to 100 subscribers, okay?
All right, so that means like each one of them is like, yes, counts for 1/10 of a view.
Literally, if he subscribes to the channel, we'll go up 20%.
Yeah.
So for real, this guy created CG 15 years ago? 12 years ago. So we all just say CG, but it's the Collective Genius. Why did you start CG?
So I know that people watching are probably looking for this just, you know, wonderful, fabulous answer, but I'm just gonna shoot it straight.
If they're watching my channel, it's not gonna be fabulous and wonderful.
Yeah, so the reality of it is at the time, I started it about 12 years ago, and it was just simply to have an additional income stream, just, you know, make a few bucks at it. But once I started it, I came to realize that it was really kind of what I was called to do. I love connecting people. My brain operates in a way that begins processing immediately when someone has a challenge who I can introduce them to fix it. And so over time, I just began to realize, like, this, I dig this. This is my jam.
Yeah. You know?
And so...
So you're he's the CCO, is what you are, the Chief Connection Officer.
That's right.
That's what he was just doing, was connecting someone who gives a presentation, talks about what they're doing well at with them, talks about what their issues are, and then he literally tees up who can help them with their issue.
Yeah, there it is. So we have the speaker's name, and then we put over here what it is they needed help with and who we need to introduce them to based upon what it is they spoke about, right? So that's really what this organization is.
So I said I've spent hundreds of thousands of dollars in coaching, but it's made me millions of dollars, and it's because I'm literally one of the dumbest people in this room, and I come here to do that on purpose. But guys like him start that idea that make it this infectious place where we can all learn and grow bigger. So CG happened because of him. We owe him a lot, and he doesn't take enough credit for how great it is for us. But
give the credit to God, my friend.
The Jason Medley.
Yeah. Pleasure meeting
you.
Now
go subscribe to Tyler Buys Houses, please.
Yeah, that's what you should do. Tyler.
You should do.
I should.
You should.
All right.
And then if he'll share it, I'm going to give him some money. He won't do it, though.
He tried to offer me $200 earlier. I told him, I was like, that's not going to get it.
It was too much. He was flattered.
No. Okay.
Hey, these guys subscribed to my channel, by the way,
yep.
So this will be on there. The Bobby Suarez.
I increased your net worth by doing
correct.
That.
I'm just here with a bunch of millionaires in Cabo. This is the Jared Irby.
Why did you join a mastermind?
Well, you got to get together with great minds like yourself.
See? We've been buddies for a while. We met at one of these.
No, masterminds are the only way to go. You got to.
We met at a group mastermind in like Florida. Pensacola.
Yeah, Pensacola.
Jared was about 200 pounds ago at that point. So
this is like 20 ago.
Yeah, sure. This is like one third Jared. But anyway, yeah. So I said, like, the title of this episode is I spend $30,000 a year to be the dumbest guy in the room. Why do you spend $30,000 a year?
Same thing. Be the dumbest guy in the room. You gotta.
He's not though.
Huh?
He's not though.
Well, I'm the second dumbest in this room.
Okay, nice. All right, but for real, if you talk about the cost of joining something, you know, I always say on the channel, I can't go to college for this, right? You can't go to college for this.
Yeah.
This is college. Like,
it's cheaper than college, first of all, and you get a 1,000x ROI. I mean, just one idea out of here.
That's what I was going to say. How much has it made you?
How much? Today? Like, probably $30,000 today.
Right.
Could be millions, you know?
Yeah.
From expanding your mind, thinking, just like a 15-minute presentation changed my mindset on something. So
one takeaway here, you get in a mastermind event, and people look at, all right, what's it cost to fly here? What's it cost for the ticket? What's it cost to be in the group?
Who cares?
Correct, because it's made
investment.
Me millions.
It's not a cost, it's an investment, you know, so that's how I look at it. It's just a pure ROI, and the ROI is hard to measure maybe, but it's infinite, you know, it's massive.
Yeah.
Like, would you invest $30,000 to potentially have a $7 million a year business? I think that would be kind of a no-brainer.
Do you think it's a wise investment if people subscribe to my channel?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, it's free. So, yeah, you should definitely subscribe. Just go online and click right here to subscribe. Tyler's a great guy. He knows what he's doing. His heart's in the right place. And, yeah, and he's not as dumb as he looks. He's actually kind of intelligent. He's from Left Virginia.
The left one.
And, you know, so I won't hold that against him.
So you're going to subscribe to Tyler Buys Houses.
I'm already subscribed to Tyler Buys Houses.
Done. So, I have to be truthful with you guys. This is day two. Yesterday was jam-packed. It was really busy, and typically we do what they call hot seats presentations on day two. On day one, but we did those. I'm getting this backwards. Yeah, no, I'm not. We do hot seats on day one, usually. And then we do the main ballroom, like, presentations day two. Well, that was backwards, and yesterday we did the main ballroom stuff. So my takeaway from yesterday is I've got to stop focusing on some of the stuff in the business that doesn't make the most revenue for us or doesn't make the needle move forward in the biggest way. So we had some takeaways from that. I haven't memorialized those yet, but today we had the hot seats. Let's just keep going. I mean, I'm such a big deal. People are probably gonna ask for autographs and stuff, but whatever. I'll just act like the
real one. Actually, did you come to film me being the bigger deal?
What's your takeaway from today?
Dude, we just said we saw Panetta's thing on NFTs and we're a little creeped out right now.
It was very informative.
Very informative, but a little creepy.
He presented?
He's a prank term, yeah.
Yeah. Very good presentation. Yeah.
It's going to be on Tyler Buys Houses, so you better go like it and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Jeez. That is Jimmy and Sarah Vreeland? Jimmy Vreeland.
Susie
Vreeland. Anyways, I didn't have like a... you're awesome. This is hard. I didn't have like a direct takeaway from today because any of the presentations that we saw, it was just more like things that people are doing to move the needle forward in their business, and a lot of that we're applying, which... I think why I didn't have such huge takeaways is because I've been coming to these for years now. Like I said, I've spent hundreds of thousands of dollars having coaching in my business. So I didn't have like something that was just that major takeaway from today, which is a good checkup. But 5% tweak in a business that does multiple millions is massive. So yeah, so for tomorrow, I really expect to have some major tweaks. We'll do a final takeaway of what the trip outcome is for us and what we're going to take back to the business that is actionable. I'll let you know that before we hit the plane. All right, it is day three, baby. We have some big, big, well-known speakers for today's sessions, but man, Paul and I had some long talks, and that's usually what happens. Found the elevator. That's what happens when you come to these events and you start to figure out what you're doing right, what you're doing wrong. You see other businesses, you see how they're pivoting, you know, with market change and just whatever. We're gonna be making some big decisions. We're gonna be making some big changes, I should say. Wow, hey. Look who comes into the elevator at the same time.
What's up? It's my lucky day.
He already texted me.
Look at that.
Like, I mean, look, it's the Eric Brewer. You guys don't even know how lucky you are to have this guy as a guest.
You guys had this elevator all to yourself, and here I come barging in.
Bro. Now, like, we've lost our train of thought.
That's right.
After day three, what's your takeaways? All right, we're starting day three, but what's your takeaways?
Biggest thing for me yesterday was the value of data.
Yeah.
And how we're probably, when I say we, I mean myself.
We can walk and talk.
Trailing behind.
We're walking and talking. Yeah. Sorry.
No, you're good.
So. Okay, I'm holding this as far as I can. I have long arms, too, yeah, but it's not.
You're pretty tall. What are you, 6'2"?
I am 6'2", but I don't have the Steve Trang people yet. You know, it's just me Trang.
Yeah, we got to start somewhere.
Right. Starting right here with the Eric Brewer. Eric buys a lot of houses in York, PA, and the surrounding area. So if you see him on Facebook, you're going to be like, yep, I definitely know that guy.
But anyway, well, you should definitely go to Tyler Buys Houses.
You should.
Yes.
If you're already watching this, you're there, but please subscribe.
Yeah.
Definitely not getting rich on this. Yeah. So the value of data, but what else?
Learned a pretty cool sales comp plan yesterday where they have sort of gamified, where they set up, like, when you hit certain milestones, you accumulate points, and then once you accumulate a certain amount of points, you can cash out and get things like Apple Watches, big screen TVs. Yeah, it was pretty cool. So
I wasn't in Eric's room, so I don't get to know what he's talking about. I know these people too. We're walking and talking. We're doing interviews here. Yeah, up to 100 subscribers.
Stephanie and Zach are hilarious.
All right, so I wasn't in Eric's room, so I don't know what he got to see, but I'm just going to say we're going to make some major changes. You're probably going to see him come in and run a quarterly for me, and we're going to talk about those changes. He doesn't know what they are yet, but he will. Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
This guy's on my channel now, too, so I'm going to get really, really, really successful.
Yeah, baby.
Right?
Buy more houses, sell more houses.
I remember Brad. There's so many nice Brads in this group.
Yeah.
What did you learn from yesterday?
What I learned from yesterday, it's really, really important to track your marketing return by rep. That was probably the most important thing I learned.
Okay.
And after flipping 4,000 houses, never did that.
4,000 houses?
Yeah.
Only 4,000?
Only 4,000.
He only did 4,000.
Yep. And if you want to learn to get really happy in your life, check me out at BradChandler6 on TikTok.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, well, you have to go subscribe.
I teach you how to find freedom and happiness.
Okay. Tyler Buys Houses.
Tyler
on YouTube.
Okay.
Tyler Buys Houses.
Sweet.
Thank you, Brad. Only 4,000 houses. That's pathetic. He needs to get moving. Okay, so obviously you guys can tell I'm one of the biggest idiots in the room, but that is why I love doing this channel. I love talking about the journey, and I love talking about the success, the failure, all of it, everything in between. But when you get around guys like that, it definitely, definitely increases what you think you can do and what your bubble looks like and what success looks like to you, because the bar is extremely, extremely high in this group, and it challenges me to think bigger all the time. So I'm excited for day three. Let's see what happens. Welcome to the Zach Betters Show.
Thanks for having me on, bro.
Yeah, man. We're nearing 107 subscribers as of the time of the shooting.
Dude, I'm excited.
So I think people like you might help me grow the channel. But anyway, in real talk, Zach and his wife Stephanie have a very high level business in Charlotte. They are called Better Path Homes, Better Path Everything.
Yeah, Better Path Homes.
Better Path Everything.
Offering the Better Path.
So, they're great friends of mine, but they have a really, really high-level business. So, question is, over the last 2 days, what has been your takeaways?
Some of my biggest takeaways have been about the idea of the importance of data, like in getting clear on our data. And every time, what I love about this group is it allows me to level up. Every time I think that I'm doing something at a high level, like you said, I see that there's another level to go. So, really, I thought we were doing good with data. I'm excited to go back and go even that next step with data. Like, where can we go from there?
So he doesn't know this because you guys are watching, but he hasn't seen the last two interviews. Literally two other people have said the same thing.
Really?
Power of data. The power of data, because it's you're won or lost in the trenches in your data. Like, that's where it all starts.
Yeah.
So for you, what do you guys do in your business? What are your primary revenue drivers?
So we have basically two verticals. So we have wholesaling, and then we have our new build construction division. So with wholesaling, it's very important that we know who we're going on appointments with, who's into our system, and who do we need to go after, and making those offers.
Yeah, and then with your new builds, you guys focus on lots and infill lots that you purchase. So you have to literally know the data of who are you actually marketing to. Why are you marketing to a specific either lot or an avatar of person or whatever?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so my takeaways have been the same thing. I'm not releasing what the big change is. I talked to his wife this morning about it. We're going to make a big business change.
It's coming.
You've told me we should make for years, so we're going to finally do it. So. I'll let you guys know that at the end of the video, but go check out Better Path Homes in Charlotte. If you're watching this from the Charlotte area, check them out. They're monsters. The Zach Betters. We have wrapped up day three, and it is now time to chill. But honestly, what I try to do is I just try to compile all the takeaways that I have from the last 3 days and compartmentalize those into what are the action items I'm going to use in the business, and what am I going to tweak about my business. So some of these I can't come public with yet because they are just changes in how we're going to operate and changes in some of the things that we may or may not do in our company, types of revenue streams we've had and types of exit strategies we utilize on our houses. But I can tell you what I'm gonna do is that I've got to start thinking even bigger than I already do. Lots of times I feel like I'm a pretty big dreamer, and as a visionary, it's like easy to be a big dreamer, but really? I can dream even bigger than I already do. And so that just, I constantly get my thought process expanded when coming to events like this. And I just can't stress enough that if you're in real estate or you're in something where you own a business or you're looking to get into it, I strongly encourage you to get mentorship, utilize what it costs you to be inside of a group, and focus on what it nets you and what it makes you when you grow your team, grow your business, grow yourself as a professional. Because I literally do not measure up to these guys even closely. And that's what makes this journey so great, is to chase greatness alongside of them. So I have three takeaways from CG, and I used to have like 36,000. And when you go to events like that and you feel like you're so low to measuring up to the people that are there, you can take away 36,000 things if you don't watch. You got to take away the things that are actionable to you, though. And that's the thing that I focused on. So I've got three takeaways, and I'm going to read them to you exactly how I wrote them down. At the top, track your dang money. Okay, what do I mean? Well, in our business, you can really easily get caught up in the day-to-day and just see that you're buying houses and see that you're rehabbing houses and that you're selling houses or that you're wholesaling houses or whatever. Inventory's coming in, inventory's going out. But it's not fun tracking down to the 10th degree and the cent on each project, but we've got to track our money better. We've got to cut the inefficiencies, and that's what I mean. So we're going to have to track everything, and I promise that will change in the business. Then the other part is narrowing the lanes of focus, both in marketing and in sales. There was a guy there, one of the biggest businesses in the room, and he said they do three things for marketing. Three. That's it. You won't find him doing anything else. And I started looking at what we do, and I'm thinking, man, we do like 7, 8, 9, 10 things in marketing. And he said, you won't be great. You won't be great at any of them. You'll be good at all of them. Be great at one or two things, and you'll do better. So I'm cutting our marketing lanes down to probably three. Direct mail, TV, and PPC. Yep, video on that later. On sales, be great at three things, two or three things. So I'm probably going to wean down some of the sales strategies we have in our company for how we sell houses and get great at like three. All right, the last one, this is the other biggest takeaway. I've just needed confirmation for this. You've heard me talk about it on the channel, and we've had issues in the business that have prevented us from doing this, but my final takeaway from CG is go to a second market. So I'm doing that. Period. No matter what, we're going to a second market. And to my defense, it's been pretty hard to make that change because we've always wanted to stay honest to the problems that we have in the company here or the things that we could do better here, because just to go run away and start a new market doesn't mean your problems will be fixed here. And I've tried to stick with that, but I think it's been to my own demise. So, second market, here we come. Watch out, Columbus, Ohio. See you guys on the next one. If you've enjoyed this content,
yes.
You want to be on my YouTube channel that has like nobody on it? See, these are great people.
What should we do?
Just say you should subscribe to Tyler Buys Houses. I would very much appreciate if you would subscribe to the channel.
Subscribe to what?
Tyler Buys Houses.
What's
that? That's the channel. That's my channel.
Oh, okay.
Tyler Buys Houses. I'm Tyler. Hit the notification bell so you know when the next chaos is coming out from Tyler Buys Houses.
Okay.
You go ahead if you want to do it.
All right. Tell them to subscribe to Tyler Buys Houses.
See, you can't even say it.
I can't even say it.
And as always, I'll see you on the next one. You guys have a great day.
Bye.